My name is Simone Spuler. My research group is part of the Experimental and Clinical Research Center, a translational cooperation between the Charité Medical Faculty and the Max Delbruck Center for Molecular Medicine in Berlin. We are interested in muscle sciences. It is very promising to exploit the potential of endogenous stem cells in repairing and restoring tissue structure and function for the treatment of tissue damage and degeneration. The rich stem cell environment may also be modulated for therapeutic purposes. However, many hurdles still need to be overcome.
I am Elena Escobar Fernandez. I am a PhD student in the group of Susanna Ishbach at the Max Delbruck Center for Molecular Medicine. We develop genetic therapies using Sleeping Beauty transposon.
In this project, we investigated human satellite cells, the endogenous and proper stem cell of skeletal muscle. Like other stem cell types, satellite cells are maintained over very long periods of time. Satellite cells are notoriously difficult to study because they are scarce and because they inhabit a peculiar specific stem cell niche, the space between basal lamina and sarcolemma of skeletal muscle. Most knowledge about satellite cells was gained from mouse experiments. Human satellite cells have hardly been investigated. We focused our project on three main aspects. First, we investigated human satellite cells. Second, we investigated and transplanted human satellite cells within their natural microenvironment, their stem cell niche. And third, we manipulated human satellite cells prior to culture or transplantation. After due approval, we obtained muscle biopsy specimens from more than 70 patients between 20 and 80 years of age. We manually dissected the muscle into single fibers or small bundles, each about 2 to 3 millimeters in length. We call these pieces human muscle fiber fragments. These fragments were analyzed for up to 3 weeks. Satellite cells can be identified readily on freshly isolated human fiber fragments. PAX7 and ANCAM are two reliable markers. The number of satellite cells per fiber fragment was very low. There was no difference whether the donors were young or old. Then we placed the fiber fragment in tissue culture. We observed that cells within the satellite cell niche remained mobile for at least 7 days. We also found that PAX7-positive satellite cells proliferated inside the fiber fragment. Later, early myoblasts arranged themselves in a fishbone pattern inside the fiber fragment, the basal lamina here in green still being intact. It took between 7 and 14 days for satellite cells to form colonies on the plastic dish outside of the fiber fragment. There were thousands of cells that outgrew a single fiber fragment, demonstrating the enormous proliferative capacity of adult satellite cells. The myoblasts fused to myotubes normally. Around 40 to 50% of cells in these cultures were PAX7-positive satellite cells. The colonies consisted of myogenic cells, but also of contaminating fibroblasts. Fibroblasts varied in their proportion between 5 and sometimes even 85%. At the time when the satellite cells were most abundant within the fiber fragment, we transplanted the fragment into the anterior tibial muscle of immunosuppressed NOD mice. If the recipient's own muscle regeneration was intact, we could observe human cells, nuclei are yellow here, in the graft tissue. However, all human nuclei remained interstitial and did not participate in muscle fibers or muscle tissue. We therefore performed local irradiation of the recipient mouse anterior tibial muscle using a focal irradiation source usually employed in highly focused irradiation of small tumors in patients, the cyberknife of the Charité. When muscle fiber fragments were transplanted into irradiated mouse muscle, human myotubes and muscle fibers were identified after 3 weeks and still after 7 weeks. Human nuclei were stained with the anti-human lamin AC antibody.
Many muscular dystrophies are monogenic diseases, meaning that they are caused by mutations in a single gene. They are therefore good candidates for gene therapy, because restoring the expression of the defective gene could potentially ameliorate the disease and improve the life quality of the affected patients. In the laboratory, we work with a sleeping beauty, a DNA transposon. Transposons are genetic elements that can mobilize in the genome. Because of their ability to jump within or into a host genome, they have been widely used as genetic tools for genome engineering and gene therapy. The image shows the mechanism of transposition of a sleeping beauty. When the transposase enzyme is expressed, it binds to its recognition sites in the transposon. It catalyzes the excision of the transposon sequence from the donor location, in this case a plasmid, and it mediates its integration into the target genome in a stable manner. In this study, we have used SB100, the hyperactive variant of a sleeping beauty transposase. We have been able to transfer a reporter gene, the fluorescent protein Venus, into human satellite cells within their anatomical niche in human muscle fiber fragments. We have showed that they can be genetically manipulated while preserving their myogenic capacity in vitro. This system also allows us to deliver large transgenes, such as the coding sequence of genes that are mutated in some muscular dystrophies.
It has been shown by others that human satellite cells may survive a few days after death. We therefore asked whether we can obtain muscle biopsy specimen and keep them or store them for a while. This obviously would have advantages in tissue handling. We stored the muscle fiber fragments for various time points at 4 degrees. We call this procedure hypothermic treatment. We found that satellite cells could endure this harsh procedure for a period of up to 5 weeks. Satellite cells were the only cell type that survived. Other cell types, like fibroblasts, however, surrendered. Therefore, we can obtain 100% myogenic cultures employing hypothermic treatment. We also transplanted muscle fiber fragments that had been subjected to hypothermic treatment into NOD mice. Transplantation was even better than transplants performed without prior hypothermic treatment. Multinucleated human muscle fibers had formed. Interstitial human cells that did not participate in regenerating muscle were hardly present. And further, PAX7-positive human cells had repopulated the satellite cell niche. Overall, we hope that our techniques will prove to be a solid foundation for the development of therapies in allogeneic and autologous settings. Stem cell activity could be enhanced for the treatment of injury, of disease, and also of age-related dysfunction.